What's up, cable dogs? Oh, hello. I don't know who we've got, if anyone. Yeah. Oh, and I'm getting my own voice back at me. It's not good. I don't like to monitor myself. These headphones are just for show. Just for me to hear the too loud music while I try and concentrate on things. So today, we're going to be being Jeff Tomsic again. I do have sad news for anyone who was following from last week. We haven't been accepted into the Lost Roleplay Discord. We haven't been rejected, but we have not been accepted, sadly. They just don't seem to be responding at all. I think the lack of members generally has probably worked against us there. Might be a little bit longer until there's anything for us to join in on. ruining the illusion a little bit. It's a little tight under the chin. So today what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to find some other places where we can jump straight in as Jeff, where we can transplant Jeff, see if there's any other roleplay worlds out there that might need a man like Jeff. And also, oh, this is a very unfortunate, this ring light, as I was saying before, the lighting has changed considerably on it. It's very bright now, and it is it's making me look like I'm wearing grills. What is it? It's a white light, and for some reason it doesn't like other white things. I had the same problem with the under the hat, which I think I might have mentioned last week as well, where it was just making this pure white cotton fake beard just very, very messy. And it's doing the same for my teeth. I do look a bit like I've got braces on today. So I'm going to switch out of this cam. And we'll introduce you to the other new thing. If you'll direct your attention to under my head there. We've got a new phone line, which should be fun. I'm going to tweet this out as well. I think I'm halfway to tweeting. Let everybody know what's going on. In the meantime, do have a nice look at all the merch. Merch store is now up. Should have a little thing about that underneath as well. It's cable2.bigcartel.com. The stream bot will tell you that. So that number, for anyone who can't read it, 8335-69-169-202. 8335-169-202. And you can text anything. Unfortunately, it only accepts text from US numbers. Anyone outside of that, which includes myself, cannot send anything in. But otherwise, it works perfectly. Thank you. anti-perv roleplay. That is the roleplay room for me, if ever there was one. Seven women to one man. Hello. This is a very immersive roleplay. Why did he just repeat his username? Because he is gay. This guy might be the strongest role player I've ever had the pleasure of working with, Sheeta. I feel like I'm not quite getting the experience I was promised from a room called Anti-Perv Roleplay. Nobody here seems to be role-playing or especially ardent about their distaste for perversion. Why must I be hated? All I did was direct the movie Tag. Okay, so we found a rich vein to mine. Reckon I can fill the next hour with a bit of embassy roleplay. Now, if there were good roleplayers in here, someone would be jumping in to be the agent to stamp the visa. It could be an hour of us waiting in line for somebody to show up at the embassy. But Jeff Tomsic is a skilled enough director. He can wring the tension out of that. Well, I'm going to have to now, because everybody knows I'm one take Tomsic. And if one of my actors does aggressive, confused baboon noises, I have no choice but to keep that in. Oh no. Hey, it's front-facing camera comedian, Meg Stelter. How we doing, Meg? What this is, as you can see, the anti-perv roleplay room, where we're deep in an intense story. I found the star of my new movie, Tag 2. I am Jeff Tomsic, director of Tag. And this person, an ingenue off the streets, saw them and I knew they had to be in my movie. Which films in Bulgaria? So we're now waiting to apply for a working visa so that we don't run afoul of local government when we start production. Now you'll notice the commitment to the role. They have wandered off, as a real person might do in this situation, in a long queue. Yeah, go for it. What's the question? I'll see if I can access Jeff, actor studio style. Good question. I mean, I'm laughing just thinking about it. Yeah, Hannibal, Ed Helms, John Hamm, not to mention Jeremy Renner, who isn't just an action hero. He's actually a very sweet, down-to-earth, funny guy, great musician as well. And yeah, I won't lie, it was hard. It was hard to keep a straight face on both sides of the camera. There are all sorts of crack-em-ups, goof-ems. And John Hamm is a real on-set prankster. Do you think he'd be the picture of professionalism, Don Draper? But yeah, he's a real cut-up. He really is. I mean, all of the funny lines that happened in the movie Tag, I mean, almost all of them were ad-libs, and you wouldn't... I mean, it was impossible to choose between them in the cutting room. You know, what stays in? Because nothing was an obvious thing to cut. You know, there were so many lines in there that I thought, God, this could be the line that makes the movie. But I've got to make room for this other line, which could be the line that makes the movie. All of the iconic lines from Tag. Tag. Tag, you're it. Hey, I thought you were it. Wait, who's it? All of that, ad-libbed. Well, I think my plan is we're going to do like Anchorman did, where they did that second mini-movie of all the deleted footage because there was just so much good stuff. So I'm going to do a Tag 1.5 before we get started on Tag 2 properly. I mean, there was enough to make a trilogy just in what we shot for the first one, which obviously we had franchise aspirations in mind. I mean, you start with a premise that strong, you just know you're going to get at least 2-3 sequels. The studios love it, especially right now where we can't really film a lot more new stuff because of this hoax that's going around about some disease of some sort. I don't know. I'm Jeff Tomsic, so I don't really need to follow the news. But yeah, they're champing at the bit. They get to make a Jeremy Renner movie without having to rehire Jeremy Renner. It's all there already. I own it. I own the footage. A tag rebuild suggests that the original foundation wasn't perfect, I would say. Why would you wouldn't rebuild the Louvre, would you? Wouldn't rebuild the Empire State Building, the Chrysler Building. Wouldn't rebuild Sydney Opera House, would you? Wouldn't rebuild the Guggenheim. Wouldn't rebuild the Eiffel Tower. What is it with my show and that word? Why am I consistently the person to introduce that to our content? At this point, I'm the common denominator. I just have to hold my hands up and realize there is something about me that invites it. Yeah, I mean, I guess I should feel good. I don't know. I mean, I know there's been a lot of contention within our community about whether it's a word that is claimable or derogatory. But I suppose for people who self-identify, I guess, yeah, maybe there is something nice that people see me. They read in my... in my text, in my character as Jeff Tomsic. Oh, another confession. Grocery. I had no idea. Well, I'm sure we could. Maybe next week's multiverse, I'll be moving on to matchmaking. Maybe I'll find you a mummy, grocery guy. I'm sure if I type in the relevant keywords into DuckDuckGo, I'll find something stream appropriate for you. You do have to assume, I think, that every scene in every movie was somebody's awakening for something, right? Like everything is somebody's attraction. Right? Everything is the thing that the way somebody's mind is wired just connects with. So I bet you're not alone. I bet there's a whole Discord, Reddit community out there for people who watched that scene and realized who they were. I realize I've just ignored. Maybe this looks very insulting that as soon as that confession was made, I just stopped talking to him. Oh, they felt the lull as well. They filled in the gap. I'm trying to nudge them. I mean, this is specifically a roleplay chat room. You think the basics. Oh, I get it. This is RP. They finally realized which room they clicked on. I will, by the end of this stream, have got everyone on board with the fact that this room is now the US Bulgarian Embassy. I agree, Grossy. You know what? When I did improv study, which obviously you'll tell I am an expert at, I always thought the yes and, obviously it has it, you know, as a broad application, that is the way to do it. But there are certain times where if you're trying to tell a real story, and obviously for comedy improv, yes and is a much bigger thing. But for regular, like dramatic improv, for regular improv, where you're just trying to tell a natural seeming story, sometimes somebody will say something to you and the answer will be no. Yeah, because otherwise you're going to get ridiculous. And sometimes, you know, a character might be lying to you. Or you might be lying to a character. Yeah, all good storytelling, and particularly good comedy, comes from a slavish devotion to boundaries and structure. Just kidding about which part do we think? Just kidding about having something to hide? Or just kidding that I shouldn't look in their pants? They are royalty free, don't worry. Everything I'm doing, I'm not going to get us with a strike. We've already had enough muting. We've had muting on things that we were fairly sure were royalty free. But I think they're being better safe than sorry. They're being extra cautious nowadays. But I'm sure part of the reason why the chat tells you what song is playing all the time, it's part of the condition of the music app that I use for this, which is specifically I feel like this anti-perv roleplay is quickly becoming a perv roleplay. Yeah, this is a little subtle psychological thing, isn't it? Oh, don't look in my pants, please. Just kidding. Unless. I think this role player thinks the Geneva Convention is a place. Which, if I am going by yes and, I guess in the world of Jeff Tomsic, the Geneva Convention was a convention, like Comic-Con. Hi, Arby. Welcome. We're continuing the adventures of Jeff Tomsic. To catch you up, they are at the US-Bulgarian embassy to apply for a working visa to film Tag 2. And there has been a murder in Geneva. That's where we're at. Can't make it more succinct than that. That's what's happened. There you go, the elusive no but. Oh, yeah, let me find it for you. This guy is the king of Nobart. What a wonderfully rich character. All of the characters in Tag 2 are meta. They're all the Randy character in Scream. So our focus group showed that everyone loves that character. They're always the breakout character. So we figured, why limit ourselves to just one Randy? Why not a whole film worth of Randys? Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, a part of me is glad that this line has been so slow. Well, my movie might have been a disaster without the input of Harold. And I would never have met a homunculus made out of my own hair. If it hadn't been for me trying to get a working visa for the cringing bystander. Funny how life works. Couldn't say for certain if I was part of the butterfly effect that led to Vladimir Putin being killed at Swiss Comic Con, or whether that would have happened whether I was here or not. Ours is not to wonder why. Ruby Ring? Where's Ruby Ring? Oh, really? No. This, well, I don't want to give away the illusion. I don't want to destroy the immersion. I'm committed to this. Obviously, you're hearing some behind the scenes stuff, but this is like me giving director's commentary for the movie. Whereas anyone just in anti-perv roleplay is just watching the movie. But I think you'll find this homunculus is somebody quite familiar. Somebody who likes to fly. Somebody with big dreams, fantasies, you might say. Somebody particularly epic. Oh, they're gonna say it. Oh, now that's subversion. I'm gonna miss Harold when Harold's gone. No, it's not a sex thing, Kay. As you can see from the title, this is the anti-perv roleplay. So it would be impossible for it to be a sex thing. That would be illegal. It's an epic tale of rings and quests and sequels to the movie Tag, 2016, director Jeff Tomsic. I don't see what you mean. It's just a couple of guys, Lady and the Tramping, a burger, biting a third guy's hand, spitting into the burger, and then continuing to eat the burger. If that sounds horny to you, I think that is something you need to examine within yourself. It's not on me. Though I will say this is maybe a bit of a departure. As episodes of Multiverse go. Don't know if I've ever done quite anything like this on the stream before. But I like it. It's calm. It's the least pressure of anything I've ever hosted. I might do this forever. I could do this for hours. Do we think a homunculus can regrow limbs like a lizard? Drake is overrated. Welcome. I'm sure you can see everything on the screen that you need to. I can't imagine you need a recap for what's happened so far on the show. It's all fairly self-explanatory. Drake, do we think Drake is perfectly rated? Underrated? Mike 850. Oh, that's just what we need on this show. Another Mike. Yeah, I think you're probably right, grocery guy. I think he's talented enough to be famous. I don't think anyone but the hardest of stands has declared him to be anything more than a decent enough musician. I think there are other aspects of Drake that perhaps need examination. But I think in terms of creativity, I think he was a good actor and a fine music maker. Socially, personally, perhaps some issues. Thank you. Thank you for the compliment on my opinions about Drake. Whoa, no way. How have you not told that story before? Was he nice? Did people have to call him Drake, or does he go by Aubrey at parties? Oh no. Well, I guess, yeah, that kind of makes sense. I think if I was Drake famous, wouldn't really matter how nice you want to be. Probably can't just hang out with everyone. No. He did aux cord DJing. That's not cool, Drake. But I mean, his persona has never really been cool, has it? Like, he never really successfully reinvented himself. He put on some muscle and he grew a beard and he sings about sex. But I think he still does come across as a dork, right? Oh yeah, that's the part. That's the part. I mean, to be fair, 21-year-old, if you hear the stories, is maybe more acceptable than other love interests. Weird that he goes by Drake now. It's so weird. Because that is a stage name, like it's a professional name. It's not, nobody called him that before. Yeah, I would be surprised if it started at 21 as well. Not to gossip, obviously. I hate to gossip, but I've heard some things. That's not very epic, but I mean it might be perfect timing because it is now quarter past where I would usually end. I know we were going to overrun a little bit, but with it being such a chill, quiet stream, I think losing my homunculus feels like the perfect time to end. We've ended on some nice gossip about Drake. I always like to bring things back to Canadian actors, as everybody knows. I have on social media a similar circle to Drake. I am mutuals with a few people that I know are friends with Drake, have worked with Drake from back in the day. Have never used it as an opportunity to say, hey, what's up with Drake? So it's nice. It's nice to find this out from another source. You've got to be famous. That is the only way to be as rated as Drake, is to get some big fellows, primes, and viewers. Click.ru. Have a friend invitation from Harold. Say goodbye to Harold. Yeah, I have told Harold about twitch.tv now. And I'm hoping that Harold will come and play with us again. Seems like the perfect vibe for a Jeff Thompson adventure. So with that, I'm going to say goodbye to all of you. I think Arby's up next with some Fantasy Flight. Whenever Arby's ready. But until next Sunday, go hang out on the Discord. Go buy some of our merch. Check out the skateboarding hoodie that I designed. The Arby tote Arby designed. The Warp Zone stuff that Null designed. The Rev Girls shirt, which looks amazing. Designed by our very own Rev Girls. Bye, everybody. See you, Starside. See you in the future for Tag 3, Tag 4, in this post-cash society, this utopia that we have designed, that all began with waiting in line at the US Bulgarian Embassy, as these things often do. I'll see you all later. Love you all. Woo!